I'm Hannah Testa, I'm 15 years old, and I'm a sophomore at West Forsyth High School. From an early age, I always remember loving the ocean and the beach. When I'm near the water, I feel like all the stress that I have within me is gone. To feel the sand in your hands and to feel the water in your toes, feeling really connected to nature. I was 10 years old when I first saw the documentary called Plastic Paradise, and that's what really opened my eyes to the issue of plastic pollution and the problems facing our oceans. Ever since seeing that documentary, I have been working on educating people about plastic pollution.
There's around 1 billion plastic straws are used worldwide every single day.
Plastic pollution is something that, even though we don't see, we are contributing to it every day. We're using plastic bags, bottles and straws, utensils. The best thing to do is not buy those plastics so that they won't be thrown away.
What is like the main source of this plastic, do you think, like on the global scale? Is this like other countries just dumping their garbage in the ocean?
Because 50% of all plastics made is single-use products, that's majority of the products they find in the ocean, and it's usually from communities like ours. If something blows out of the landfill, or if you throw something out of your car window, or something falls out from the trash can, they will probably end up in your sewers or go into the creek nearby, and they all end up connecting into our oceans. So one of the challenges I face is finding people that really connect to the ocean because we're not so close to it. Finding people that connect the dots that we are having an impact on our oceans even if we don't see it every day, even if it's several hours away. For quite a while now, I'm working with politicians and speaking at schools in my community or doing cleanups in my area, either on the streets or on the river or lakes, because those all end up in the ocean. Our oceans are like a rubber band, and you can keep pulling it and it'll come back, but there'll be one point where you pull it so far that it'll break. We're so close that we'll end up losing our oceans, our coral reefs, our food systems for so many other people. I feel like we're not appreciating what we have, and once we lose it, it's gone. It's really amazing to see so many kids stepping up and using their voices to make changes. We're gonna be the ones that are gonna live on this planet with all the issues that our world's facing. We're going to be our next leaders, our politicians, our workers. We're going to be our future. Whether you know it or not, if you're right by the coast or if you're hundreds of miles inland, we are all affected by the ocean. The one thing that I commit to doing to help protect our oceans is educating people of the importance of our oceans and keeping it as beautiful as it is.